Let's look at one case study on cost plus method, and this seems to be the one which is favorite for the examiners. Generally, in every one or two attempts, I've seen that they are putting this thing in some form or shape or the other. So stay your attention here, focus on this, and I'm 100% sure you will be able to get this very, very easily. It's just a matter of concept. DoorLock India is a company incorporated under the Companies Act 2013, a wholly owned subsidiary of DoorLock USA. Since it is a wholly owned subsidiary of DoorLock USA, that means what? It's a related enterprise, an associated enterprise, and therefore transfer pricing is applicable. And has a factory in Haryana. It is engaged in manufacture of door locks, door handle, and other security products. Amongst several other products, the company manufactures category A door lock, for which the details are as under. So they are manufacturing some door locks and the details are as under. The cost of steel to manufacture door lock is 40. Other direct cost, including logo affixing charges, is 20, which makes the total direct cost as 60. Indirect cost is 20, and therefore the total cost is 80. Now there are some details which are given to you, and let's look at them. During financial year 18-19, it sold 500,000 pieces of such locks to DoorLock USA at 100 per lock. So the price at which the transaction has taken place between two related parties is 100, including transportation cost. There were following differences which were available between the sale of category A door lock to third party buyers. So when they were selling it to third party buyers, the cost was as under. Third party require affixing their logo on the locks, for which indirect tax cost of rupees 2 per lock is incurred. So we saw that the total cost was 80, which included the cost of affixing the logo. But what you are told is that this logo is not required to be put in the case of DoorLock USA. To make the two price comparables, what I need to do is I just need to remove that cost, which is not included in both the cases, out of this cost. So I will remove 2 rupees from the cost of 80 because I want to make these two transactions comparable. Credit period of 6 months is given to third parties, while sale to DoorLock USA is on advance basis. This credit cost can be assumed at 0.5% per month of and included indirect cost of the product. So you are told that the direct cost is 60. There's a credit period which is given to third parties. How much? The credit period is 6 months and credit cost is 0.5%, which means for 6 months at 0.5%, it is 3% of the direct cost. How much is the direct cost? 60. So 3% of 60 will make it 1.80 rupees. So this is a benefit which is given to third parties and it is included in the direct cost. So because this total cost included the direct cost, so I will reduce this 1.80 from here, which leaves me with 76.20. Goods are sold and delivered to DoorLock USA at their warehouse, while in case of third parties, goods are delivered at the godown of the seller. Additional transportation cost is 10 per unit. So between related and unrelated parties, there is a difference of 10 rupees between the price. Assume there is no markup on the freight charged by the company. So in case of cost plus method, what I do is generally I ascertain the cost and then I apply a markup. Now you are told there is this one cost, but you're not supposed to charge a markup on this. So therefore, when I'm making these adjustments, I will not make this adjustment before making the markup. Compute the arm's length price, assuming a margin of 25% on the cost is earned from unrelated parties. So my first question was, first part of the question was, I need to ascertain the comparable price, and that comes to 76.2. On this 76.2, I need to have a margin of 25%. 25% of 76.2 will make it 19.05. And when I add the two of them, I get 95.05. So this is the price I should be charging from my related party, right? But then there is also a 10 rupee additional cost which I am incurring to deliver the goods to the warehouse of Doorlock USA. If you actually carefully read, it says goods are delivered at the godown of the seller. What means? The goods are actually delivered at the godown of the seller. And who's the seller? Doorlock India. So in this case, basically, while to third party, I'm delivering the goods at my warehouse, in case of USA, I'm sending it to their warehouse. So this additional cost will actually be what? It will be a cost which will be incurred towards Doorlock USA. So I will add this to cost here, which gives me 105.05 as the arm's length price. But what is the price I have charged? I have charged 100. So therefore, the difference that needs to be done is 5.05. How many units have I sold? 5 lakh. So 5 lakh into 5.05, which is how much? It is going to be, I think, 25,25,000. Let's just look at it in the next slide. So here we go. The adjustment is 5.25 per unit. At 5 lakh per unit, it will be 26,25,000. So the total transfer pricing adjustment which will be done will be 26,25,000.